Cell metabolism is the oxidation of carbon compounds. Almost every carbon of glucose has a single bond to one oxygen atom. Glucose is oxidized to pyruvate in glycolysis, and pyruvate is further oxidized to carbon dioxide during the citric acid cycle. Most carbon atoms in fatty acids are hydrocarbons. They're reduced carbon atoms with no bonds to oxygen. Fatty acids are first oxidized to acetyl-CoA, and then they enter the citric acid cycle. During the citric acid cycle, a series of oxidation steps oxidizes acetyl-CoA to carbon dioxide. For an example of a redox reaction in glycolysis, think about the oxidation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, or G3P, into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, or 1,3-BPG. This is a phosphorylation reaction that occurs in glycolysis. We could assign charges to all the carbon atoms and count their electrons to see that electrons are lost in this step, or we can simply count the bonds between carbon and oxygen to see that 1,3-BPG is more oxidized than G3P. In G3P, there are four bonds between carbon atoms and oxygen atoms, two in this double bond and two single bonds, whereas in 1,3-BPG, there are five bonds between carbon and oxygen. As a phosphate group was added, G3P was oxidized to 1,3-BPG. Oxidation is always paired with reduction. In this step, NAD+ is reduced to NADH. Here's NAD+, or nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. The relevant part of NAD+, the part that changes in this reduction, is highlighted in black. If a hydrogen atom is added to NAD+, it can form NADH, which looks like this. This hydrogen atom carries an electron with it, and another electron comes along too, and those extra electrons reduce NAD+ to NADH. Even just by looking at the charge on the molecule, you can see that NAD+ is the oxidized form, while NADH is the reduced form. In order to go from a positively charged molecule to a neutral molecule, electrons must be gained, and gaining electrons is reduction. So in this step, G3P is oxidized to 1,3-BPG, and NAD+ is reduced to NADH. Along the way, one hydrogen ion is formed and it dissociates into the cell. This redox reaction is catalyzed by glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase, or G3PDH. Because the delta G of this reaction is small, the reaction is readily reversible. Finally, we see redox reactions that involve metal ions in the electron transport chain. During the rest of metabolism, NAD+ molecules were reduced to NADH, and FAD was reduced to FADH2. In this tutorial, we'll focus on what happens to NAD+ and NADH, but redox reactions apply in a similar way to FAD and FADH2. The body has a limited supply of NAD+, which are regenerated at the electron transport chain. At the inner mitochondrial membrane, NADH loses electrons to be oxidized to NAD+, regenerating NAD+ that can be used in glycolysis and the citric acid cycle. Oxidation is always coupled with reduction. These electrons don't just float inside the cell. Iron atoms of NADH dehydrogenase complex are reduced. Before gaining these electrons, these iron atoms were iron 3+. As they pick up electrons from NADH, iron 3+ are reduced to iron 2+. Redox reactions occur in every step along the electron transport chain. The iron 2+ ions in NADH dehydrogenase are oxidized back to iron 3+ as they pass electrons to ubiquinone, a lipid-soluble electron carrier that travels from NADH dehydrogenase complex to cytochrome BC1 complex. Part of ubiquinone is drawn here below. In the oxidized form, ubiquinone looks like this. As it picks up two electrons from NADH dehydrogenase complex, ubiquinone is reduced to this form. Ubiquinone is oxidized back to its original form when it passes the electrons off to iron 3+ ions of cytochrome BC1 complex, which are reduced to iron 2+. The reduced iron 2+ of cytochrome BC1 complex are oxidized back to iron 3+ as they pass electrons to cytochrome C, another mobile electron carrier. Cytochrome C is oxidized back to its original form as it passes electrons off to iron 3+ of cytochrome oxidase complex. Those iron 3 plus ions are reduced to iron 2 plus. Finally, the iron 2 plus ions of cytochrome oxidase complex are oxidized back to iron 3 plus as they pass electrons off to two hydrogen ions and an oxygen atom, forming water. In this last equation, it's the oxygen atom that is reduced. It's the final electron acceptor. So in the electron transport chain, electrons are passed from NADH to NADH dehydrogenase complex, to ubiquinone, to cytochrome BC1 complex, to cytochrome C, to cytochrome oxidase complex, and finally to oxygen, forming water. In the next tutorial, we'll look at the thermodynamics of the electron transport chain to see why this whole electron relay is advantageous.